Hi guys, Firebugs here. I come to you with the second segment of Building Umbara. Of course, sorry for the late delay on uploading this video. I've actually got an upcoming project, which of course the trailer is out just now, of a stop motion, and that's probably why this video is out so late. Of course, it's only the day after, but still. But in this episode, you will of course see the building of this beautiful gunship, which of course I still got to do a review on. The layout of the actual mock itself, and then a couple of progress updates on this gunship, as well as a couple of updates on the mock itself, which may include some information about the Umbaran tanks, and of course the actual layout or design of the actual mock itself. Now of course you guys went from plan one, so, or idea one. So, yeah guys, let's dive straight into building the gunship. So, yep guys, after day one, of course, we have day one of building the Republic gunship. For day one, I managed to get the main base here. As you can see, still not entirely complete, so I've still got some tiles to add on and things like that. Front is looking quite good. Might add in a little bit more tiles here. Unfortunately for the actual cockpit piece here, I'm unable to fit an actual minifigure inside, so I might end up just using like a couple of pilot minifigure heads and put them in here. And unfortunately the reason for that is, of course, not necessarily the gaps, but it'd be quite hard to do, and I'm kind of run out of pieces for that. As well as the fact that it wouldn't look quite right. Of course, slopes going up here. Main space here, of course, I've got a clone minifigure in there. He's sitting quite happy there. And there's quite a lot of space back here. And then towards the back, I'm gonna have to try and get this tiled off a little bit more, but it's a small door that you see with it, and of course it leads into the main cockpit area, and that just closes up. And then you have the, well, I figured out the like the main type of feature for the door, and so I got that done, as you can see. Of course it's not completely done yet, so there'll be a, but hopefully I should get it done today, because this is day two, and I'm just about to upgrade this. But I just wanted to give you a small update of it. Of course, quite a lot of pieces here, so I'll be using more of these. I'll be, of course, making things much more smooth, and obviously getting the wings done. So, yeah guys, that's it for day one. So you guys, after day two, of course I have just about the finished Republic gunship here, and now I will of course be doing a video on that. It'll probably be out by the release of this video, so you guys stay tuned for that, or at least go and watch it. I'm pretty sure there'll be a link in the description below to that, or like a small pop-up card if I figure out how to do that. But the main parts of the Republic gunship, of course you have all the details. I was actually able to fit in the doors quite well. Couple of wedge plates and things like that for dark red with the colours. Then you have the two kind of fuel cells towards the top. Made using a couple of wheels. Now the front here, of course, unable to fit a minifigure. But I still think it looks really cool. You can actually kind of open up this part, but that's about it for the cockpit. Down here, of course, you have the two guns that are kind of a bit weird looking, but I'm pretty sure that's how they look. And then, of course, you have the front part here, which is made nice and smooth. I'm really happy with the way the front turned out. So yeah, of course. Turn it around. As you can see, nice smooth kind of texture. Now, for the actual... if I move this out of the way, yes, I know I've taken quite a lot of plates and things, etc. there. As you can see, I figured out the feature for the door. All you have to do is... This is a bit hard with one hand, but I cannot be bothered getting my tripod out, but here we go. Of course, you can open it up at both sides, and that's, I kind of changed the feature a little bit, because I didn't have enough of those pieces, so it's just jointed on one side, and I'm really happy with the way it turned out. I might upgrade it a little bit more to make it a little bit more stable, but as you can see there, there is of course a clone minifigure in there, and you can actually fit quite a few minifigures inside of there. And then the space towards the back, if I get this back in, and yeah, if you want to just put the door back in, just push it in like that, and it fits in seamlessly. At the back here, I kind of upgraded this part a little bit more. It's a little bit taller with this door here. As you can see, it's a little bit hard to access. But with a few nudges, you are able to get it. And it's a bit dark in there, but it leads to the main cockpit, like the previous one. So yeah, guys, that's it for the Republic gunship. Of course, now let's go on to the actual layout of the whole. Putting out like plates and things like that. If my camera will focus, there we go. Of course, putting out the layout, of course, for this. So that would be, of course, you guys all chose idea one, so I'll be laying that down right now. And of course, it'll be heading into a time lapse. So you guys, that's it for the layout. Of course, I have a couple of minifigures lined up, as well as a couple of vehicles about. Of course, you can see the clone turbo tank. It just about fits in there, as well as my Republic gunship, which may of course be like higher up in the air or something like that. So of course, two hills, smaller hill here, and another smaller hill that's attached to that. Of course, this hill won't be too big because of course you've got a turbo tank that needs to technically ram up it. And then Umbaran tanks will be here, as well as a couple of other CIS or Umbaran type of fighters, etc. Unfortunately for the Umbaran tank, I'm going to have to make it mid-scale because I do not have enough pieces in order to make it full-size. So, yeah, that's it for the Umbaran tank. And, yeah guys, let's go to the final part of this video. So, yeah guys, that's going to be it for week 2 of Building Umbara. Of course, we got the layout done. We got the Republic gunship, etc, etc. Of course, I will be hopefully ordering a bit more bricks coming, well, over the next couple of weeks in order to get this whole lot here covered in, like, mountains, etc, etc. I still need to try and find some vine pieces to, you know, put about Umbara, but, like I said, it may have actually been delayed because, of course, I was doing a stop motion, which is at the moment, the trailer for that is out at the moment on the channel. But, apart from that, of course, building smaller Umbaran tanks, etc, etc, which, of course, will hopefully be done next week. Yeah, guys, that's going to be it for Building Umbara week 2. And hopefully we should be getting onto landscape and of course building the Baron tanks. So yeah guys, I'm Inferno Bricks and I'll see you guys later. Peace out.